It's been back to school season in the US for a few months, and that means only one thing for most elementary kids and their parents. It's lice season. The much dreaded tiny animal is notorious for infecting the heads of children, who often don't practice the same hygiene practices that adults do, and thus leave themselves vulnerable to infection. All it takes is one child, and soon an entire classroom can be host to these tiny little creepy crawlies. But what happens if you actually do get lice, and what's the best treatment for them? Once more, we're turning to our favorite lab rat as we challenge him to deal with a lice infestation. Day 1. What the actual bleep is literally what I said on the phone with the infographic show after they sent me an email telling me my next challenge. It's back to school season, they said. People want to know about lice, they said. You could help people find out how to treat them, they said. And after a renegotiation of my fee, I finally relented and accepted. The next day, today, I got a package via private courier, and after signing for it, I brought it inside and just stared at it, knowing what was inside. Finally, I opened the box up and revealed several plastic tubes, and inside were what looked like small white dots, except they were moving. I was holding a box full of lice, and pretty soon they were going in my hair, just so I could find out what the best way to destroy them was. Well, I could just chuck them in a fire right now and that sorted out, wouldn't it? But no, that's not what I'm getting paid to do. And believe me, I'm getting paid very well for what I'm about to do. So first, I'm home alone, which is the only way I could do this challenge. The girlfriend is in Canada filming something, or else I know there'd be no way she'd let me do this. She's a clean freak, and infesting myself on purpose with lice ranks up there with, honestly, I don't know. There's nothing I could compare it to, but I'm pretty sure she would make me move out and only allow me back in when she's run me through full military nuclear, biological, and chemical warfare decontamination techniques. I told her over the phone, and she just gave off a really deep sigh. I think a year ago, she would have put up a fight, but by now, she just sort of accepts the insanity I go through sometimes for my job. She made me swear I would boil all of our sheets and basically clean the entire house when it was over and before she got home, so thanks, infographics. Okay, so that's the little effect these buggers are already having on my social life. What can I expect them to do to me physically? Well, lice come in three varieties: head lice, body lice, and the infamous pubic lice or crabs. Pubic lice are kind of a misnomer though, because any lice you get in your crotch are automatically pubic lice. Basically, all lice live amongst your hairs and then move down to your skin so they can bite you and feed on your blood, like tiny disgusting little vampires. The resulting bites can be itchy, and though lice are not generally thought to be disease vectors, their bites can be so itchy that you inadvertently tear the skin open and cause infection. Not gonna lie, I am relieved to hear that there's little risk of these things carrying disease. Plus, infographics promised me that they were, quote, laboratory level sterile, end quote. Whatever in the world that means. You know what? I don't want to know. I literally have no desire to know from where in the world infographics got their hands on what are apparently medical quality lice. I did do some research online, and apparently you can even get lice in the mail, though, but I very quickly ended my search. So I'm going to be testing a variety of different treatments for getting rid of lice. And I'll be purposefully pouring them into my hair. I've never had pubic lice and never intend to, so that's off limits. I'll start with some homeopathic remedies and then move on to the real stuff, actual medicine. Spoiler alert, homeopathy is not a thing, so I'm confident none of those remedies will actually work. Hence why I saved the real medicine for last. The treatments I'll try are tea tree oil, lavender oil, vodka, yes, you heard that right, and finally actual medicine in the form of shampoo designed to kill lice and their eggs. Looking at this list, I'm actually kind of thinking the vodka may have a pretty good chance of killing off the lice along with the shampoo, and I'm talking about real vodka here, not the wimpy stuff you buy at the grocery store. I once was assigned to teach firearms handling to Ukrainian forces, and they introduced me to Ukrainian vodka so strong it'll strip rust off of steel bolts, and you can totally buy it online. My first try nearly burned a hole through my gut, so I'm pretty confident this is going to destroy the lice. Treatment 1. Tea tree oil. Okay, so lice went in the hair a few days ago, and per the instructions I was given, I gave them a day to settle in. You know, unpack their bags, get used to their new home, which is my freaking head. But also because apparently these guys do not live very long without human or animal hosts, because they starve to death, which explains why I was sent so many lice at once. Apparently at least half of them were probably dead already. Their one free day was so they could feed and recuperate, and if you don't think I was freaking out over purposefully playing host to a bunch of bugs in my hair, then you're thinking wrong. We love tea tree oil, don't we? I mean, you saw it touted online as the solution to literally anything. Apparently, Aboriginals in Australia used it for its medicinal properties for thousands of years, and it does have some medicinal qualities to it. And it's all natural, which means overprivileged first worlders geek out and pay a 3,000% markup for it. I get it, it just feels good to use something all natural, just like Mother Nature intended. Don't take harsh chemicals or drugs, just fall into the loving arms of Mother Gaia and let her love heal the hurt away with all the natural vibes. Except it didn't work. At all. And I applied it extremely generously to my head and let it sit for half an hour, then rinsed it out. Got out a knit comb I picked up at the store and started going through my hair. There were a number of clearly dead lice, but it seems like most were happily moving around, going about their lives, probably thanking me for the all-organic bath they just had while going to their local lice Starbucks for a nice lice frappuccino made from fair trade beans. So I repeated the treatment again a day later, once more doused my head with tea tree oil, let it sit, rinsed it out, ran a comb through my hair, same result. Not as many dead lice as the first time, still plenty of living lice. I did it one more time, exact same result. So tea tree oil clearly has some anti-lice properties, but as the problem with every homeopathic treatment, those properties are in too low concentrations to really have a definitive effect. That's why drugs and chemical treatments are so much more effective. They concentrate the effective ingredients to a level that homeopathy doesn't even approach. If you're a fan of TED Talks, there's one given by James Randi where he eats an entire bottle of homeopathic medicine at once, which he can, of course, totally do because the only active ingredients in the entire bottle are in such low quantities that they have practically no effect on the body. Try that with real medicine though and, well, you'll probably really hurt yourself. Treatment 2. Lavender oil. So I gave my little buddies a few days to recuperate from the tea tree oil and my head's been an itchy mess. I've purposely been not leaving the house because, well, I have a head full of lice, so other than dealing with itchiness, it's been kind of lonely and boring. Also, I miss my girlfriend, but I'm glad she's not here to deal with this. Alright, lavender oil. How does it work? Well, if possible, lavender oil worked even less than tea tree oil, which I would label about 50% effective. I'm giving lavender oil about 30% effective, and I'm pretty sure that none of the dead lice I found were actually killed by anything in the oil itself, probably just drowned to death. If you go to clearlice.com and look up lavender oil, it'll tell you about how evil over-the-counter medicines and shampoos are dangerous for you. They use hot-button words like chemicals and pesticides and neurological and developmental problems. What they don't do is give you any perspective. Yes, the chemicals involved in over-the-counter treatments could in fact be harmful, but only if you were to consume them in astronomically high doses. One of those chemicals, permethrin, is found in many lice shampoo treatments, but if you search for its toxicity, you'll find the dose at which it becomes lethal for 50% of test rats exposed to it is 270 milligrams per kilogram of body weight. And even then, if only injected directly into the veins of the animal. When you extrapolate that to human toxicity, you'll basically have to inject an entire bottle of lice shampoo directly into your veins for it to have a 50% chance of killing you. Honestly, if you're getting adverse effects from lice shampoo, it's probably because you're supposed to be using it on your head, not injecting it into your freaking veins. Oh, also at clearlice.com, they explicitly say that lavender oil does not kill lice, yet thousands of websites recommend it as an all-natural treatment. That's kind of hilarious. Treatment 3. Vodka. Hey, you know what's super not a good idea? Pouring 170-proof vodka imported from Eastern Europe directly onto your scalp. Do you guys remember the terrible Ghost Rider movie? Yeah, that's exactly what my head felt like after bending over in front of the tub and pouring very strong and very expensive vodka into my hair. I'm not gonna lie, I tried it once, only because I can take feeling like I'm being chemically scalped once in my life. I hear it's a popular remedy in Russia, but Russians also commonly throw babies into snowbanks before major surgeries to slow their heart rates. I'm not saying it's not effective, I'm just saying there's more non-Russian ways of doing things. As far as killing lice, honestly, I don't know. I couldn't even stand touching my head for a day after this, so I didn't even bother checking. Pretty sure all I did was give my head lice the best party of their life. Treatment 4. Actual medicine. Okay, so my final treatment, I went ahead and consulted with a pharmacist who recommended a specific type of shampoo. Apparently, lice are becoming resistant to the chemicals we've been using for decades, which makes sense, that's just how evolution goes. So the pharmacist recommended a shampoo that uses dimeticone, or a type of silicone. If you love homeopathy and fear chemicals, then this is the stuff for you because it kills lice mechanically, rather than with chemicals that attack its biology. The dimeticone physically coats the lice and essentially makes it impossible for them to breathe, which kills them. It's less effective on eggs, but that's why you're supposed to continue the treatment over the course of several days, killing the new generation before it has a chance to lay eggs. So that's what I did. And let me tell you, this stuff stinks. It smells really strong, and you have to leave it in for several hours, which is not a huge selling point, to be honest. But later that night, I rinsed it out and ran a comb through my hair and found more dead lice than I've found to date with any other treatment. I kept repeating the treatment, and each day I was finding less and less live lice. This was clearly the most effective method I've tried yet. It's now been a week since my last treatment, and I'm happy to report that I appear to be 100% lice free. This has been a horrible past few weeks, and one of the grossest challenges I've done, but I'll take some small satisfaction in knowing that I murdered an entire generation of lice while they were still virgins. Small payback, but I'll take it. Have you ever had lice? How would you try to treat them if you got them? Let us know in the comments, and if you like this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more and less gross, great content.